Welcome to tutorial 6 of electric power system. Here we are going to discuss the problems and solutions on short transmission line. The tutorial will be divided into two parts. In the first part we'll discuss 4 questions and in the second part we'll discuss another 4 questions. So problem number 1, here the problem is asked as you have a single phase overhead transmission line which is delivering 1100 kilowatt and 33 kV at 0.8 power factor lagging. So the first thing that we have to observe is whether our system is single phase or three phase. So once we have understood that yes, our system is single phase or three phase, then we can proceed ahead. So the information of the load side is given to us. So the information of the load is given as it is delivering, so the receiving end voltage is 1100 kilowatt. Receiving end power is 1100 kilowatt at a voltage of 33 kilovolt, whereas the power factor is 0.8. So this is the information given on the receiving side for the power, voltage and power factor. So we have understood that since the system is single phase, these quantities are single phase quantities. Other problems we will see for three phase too. Now the total resistance and inductive reactance of the line are given to you. Since it is a short transmission line, we know that in the short transmission line, we will neglect the shunt capacitance. So we have been given the values of the resistance, that is 10 ohm, and 15 ohm is the value of the reactance, and a load is connected at the receiving end and this is our sending end voltage. So since this is a single phase transmission system, we need not to change anything. We'll just use the data whatever is given. Now we have to obtain what is the sending end voltage, what is the power factor of the sending end and what is the transmission efficiency. So these particular things we have to obtain from the problem number 1. Now let us see. So given condition is that the power factor of the receiving end is 0.8 and the total line impedance is given to be 10 plus J15, that is R plus JXL. Then the receiving end voltage is 33 kV. Since it is a single phase, so this is basically the phase voltage. Now you can obtain the line current. We know the formula for power is equal to V phase I phase into cos phi. From here we have been given the value of power and we have been given the value of the voltage and the power factor. So the only unknown is the current. So we can obtain that current, which is the phase current or equal to the line current, because it is a single phase quantity, that will give you 41.67 ampere. Also we know that cos phi r, that is the receiving end power factor, is 0.8. So sine phi r value will be 0.6. Now we will start from the receiving end quantity. That is, we will take the receiving end quantity as the reference. So if we take the receiving end quantity as the reference, it means it will be on the zero axis. So receiving end vector would be equal to the receiving end magnitude with an angle of 0 degree. Then other quantities we can obtain based on the reference quantity. So we have been given that the 33 kV is the receiving end voltage. Then what is the current flowing in this circuit? So the current flowing is basically the current vector is basically the magnitude of the current and the angle of minus phi, because you have been given the lagging power factor condition. right? So we have obtained the value of cos phi r and sin phi r, and we have also obtained the magnitude of the current. So the value of the magnitude is 41.67, and the cos phi r and sin phi r component we have calculated. So this is the current vector which we have obtained. Next, we have to obtain the sending end voltage. We know that we can write a KVL equation in this loop. So the sending end voltage is basically, so this is the total impedance of the line, and this is equal to the receiving end voltage of the line. So this circuit, and here you have the flowing the current I. So if we write the KVL equation, what you will get? The sending end voltage is equal to receiving end voltage plus the current multiplied with the impedance. Now these are all vector quantities. So we will take all as vector quantities, and then we will substitute the value of VR, current and the impedance. So after substituting, we are getting this value of sending end voltage. So the magnitude of the sending end voltage we have to calculate. So it is basically under root the real square plus the imaginary square. So the real quantity is 33708.3 and the imaginary quantity is 250. So you are getting 33709 volt as the sending end voltage. Now we have to determine in the next case what is the sending end power factor, that is cos of phi s. So before that, we will see that the value of phi s, that is the sending end power factor, is the angle between the voltage and the current. So phi s will be equal to phi r plus alpha. Phi s will be equal to phi r plus alpha. Phi r is basically the angle between the receiving end voltage and the current, and alpha is the angle between the Vr and Vs. So we have obtained both Vr and Vs, so from which we can calculate what is the value of alpha. So value of alpha is basically tan inverse, that is the angle we have of the magnitude of the Vs. So here you have the imaginary quantity Q, and here you have the real quantity P. So divide the Q by P. So this you will get the value of alpha, which is equal to 0.42. Then the sending end power factor phi s will be equal to phi r plus alpha. So phi r is basically the power factor angle of the receiving side plus 0.42, that is we have obtained here. So it is 37.29. So this angle plus phi r plus alpha, you will get the value of phi s. Next, what is the sending end power factor? Now you have obtained the power factor angle. So cos phi s will give you the sending end power factor, which is coming to be 0.7956, because the angle is 37.29. So cos of 37.29 will give 0.7956. Now we have to determine what is the efficiency. So efficiency is basically power output by power input, and input power can be written as power output plus losses. So we have to calculate what is the total loss in the transmission line. So here you will get I square R as the losses in the line, where the resistance is given to be 10 ohms and the magnitude of the current is 41.67. So you will get 17.64364 kilowatt as the line losses. And the power output is basically is given in the question as 1100 kilowatt. Then the power sent, because you have power input is equal to power output plus losses. So power output is 1100 kilowatt plus the losses you have calculated as 17.364. So you add it, you will get the value of power sent as this much. Then it is easy to calculate the transmission efficiency as power delivered, that is power output by power input into 100, which gives you 98.44% as the transmission efficiency of the line. Now there is an other way from the vector diagram that you can use to calculate this problem of Vs and Phi S. So directly we know that the formula of Vs is this approximately, which comes from the vector diagram, phasor diagram of the transmission line, short transmission line. So Vs is equal to Vr plus Ir cos phi r plus Ixl sin phi r. Please look into the lecture video to understand where from this formula comes. So we can directly substitute the values of Vr and all the current, resistance and reactance, which will get 33708.39, and we'll see that it is approximately the same as we have obtained in the previous case. And the value of cos phi s we can again substitute from the values of the phasor diagram. So this cos phi s is equal to this value Vr cos phi r plus Ir divided by Vs. So here we are getting a cos phi s as 0.7958, which is approximately equal to 0.8 power factor. So in this way, we can solve the problems of short transmission line, single phase transmission line. Problem number two is, what is the maximum length in kilometer? That is, we have to calculate the length of the transmission line, and the transmission line is single phase, which is having a copper conductor of 0.775 centimeter square cross section, over which 200 kilowatt at unity power factor condition. So basically, the power output is given to be 200 kilowatt, power factor is unity, and the voltage is 3300 volt, which is equal to the receiving end voltage. So this is the receiving end. It is equal to cos phi r. So the efficiency of the transmission is given to be 90%. And the specific resistance of the material copper is given to be 1.725 micro ohms centimeter. So you have to determine what is the length of the transmission line. What is the length of the transmission line? So let us see. So receiving end power is given to be 200 kilowatt. Transmission efficiency is 0.9, and we know from the formula efficiency is power output by power input. So power output is given, efficiency is given, we can easily calculate what is power input. So power input, that is the sending end power, is this much. Okay. Next, we can calculate the losses. So losses is basically power input minus power output. So if we subtract the power input minus power output, we'll get the losses. The total losses in the line is coming to be 22 watt. Then the current we can easily calculate. Current calculation is equal to P equal to V cos phi. So cos phi is coming to be unity, because it is a unity power factor condition, and this is a single phase transmission line. So the power is given to be 200 kilowatt, the voltage is given to be 3300, cos phi is 1, so we can easily calculate the value of the current as 60.6 ampere. Now, since it is a single phase line and R is basically the resistance per conductor, so in single phase we know there will be two conductor, so the total line losses will be equal to 2I square R, right? Now here we have been given what is the total line losses is there. So P loss we know, and we know what is the value of the current, so we can determine what is the resistance of the line per conductor. So resistance is coming to be 3.025 on substitution. Then the length of the transmission line can be calculated from the formula R is equal to rho L by A. So resistance is calculated, rho is given, area cross section is given, so we can calculate the length of the transmission line. So length of the transmission line is coming to be 13.6 kilometer. So we know that any transmission line whose length is less than 80 kilometer will come under short transmission line. So here we are getting 13.6 kilometer. Problem number three. Now our calculation will start for three phase transmission line. So if you have an overhead three phase transmission line which is delivering, now whatever the load information is given to us, that is the power at the receiving end is 5000 kilowatt, and the voltage at the receiving end is 22 kV, and the power factor cos phi r is given to be 0.8 power factor. Now this information is pertaining to the three phase quantities, that is the power is three phase and this voltage is the line voltage, which was again in single phase these quantities was line quantity and phase quantities was equal. But however, in these, since it is a three phase system, we have to convert the three phase quantities into single phase quantities, and then only we need to solve the problem. So that is the difference of a three phase system and a single phase system. Now in a three phase system, all the quantities that is given to you, you have to convert it into single phase equivalent. The resistance and the reactance, whatever is given, it is corresponding to single phase. So 4 plus J6 is basically the total impedance of the single phase line. So again, you have to determine the sending end voltage, if regulation of the line, voltage regulation and efficiency. So these are the three things we have to determine. And remember, this is a three phase system. So cos phi r is given to be 0.8. So the receiving end voltage, which is again the line quantities was given, so convert it into phase quantities by dividing it with root 3. So you are getting 12700 volt. Impedance is 4 plus J6. Then the current formula will change now, because the current is equal to 3 times the voltage phase, current phase and cos phi. You remember here the 3 term has come because it is a 3 phase system. So the power that is being given to you and the voltage is given, the cos phi is given to you. So find the value of the current. So this current, line current, is equal to 164 ampere, which is the phase current of the system, which is the phase current of the system for a single phase equivalent circuit. Now cos phi r and sin phi r we can obtain. Then the again we'll take the reference as the value of the VR. So the reference is the receiving end voltage, which will have an angle, and this angle will be 0 degree, that you, it is there on the zero axis. So this is a 0 degree, correct. Now the current that we have obtained is 164 ampere, that is the magnitude, and we have seen that the power factor cos phi r is 0.8, so sin phi r will get 0.6. So cos phi r minus j sin phi r will get a value of the current. Next, we can calculate similarly the value of Vs. So Vs, we know that it will be equal to Vr plus the current into impedance, KVL equation in the short transmission line. So we'll get the value of Vs as this. Magnitude will calculate under root the real square plus imaginary square, similarly whatever we have calculated in the problem number 1. So here we are getting 13820.8 volt. Now there is a little bit difference. Remember here that since it is a three phase system, we can't stick to this answer, rather we have to multiply with root 3 so that we convert the phase quantity into line quantity. So line quantity is basically root 3 times the phase quantity, and this gives the magnitude of the line voltage sending end. We know that the percentage regulation of the line is sending end voltage minus receiving end voltage by receiving end voltage into 100, which is nothing but the no load voltage minus full load voltage by full load voltage into 100. So this is the voltage regulation of the line. So sending end voltage we have calculated, receiving end voltage is calculated. So we can obtain the voltage regulation of the line by dividing it with receiving end voltage. And we have to determine the efficiency of the line. So total line losses we have to multiply it with 3 times, which was 2 times in case of single phase transmission line. And if the total resistance is given, then the line losses will be equal to I square R. If R is the total resistance, if R is not the total resistance, then 2I square R will be there for single phase, and for three phase system, it will be equal to 3I square R. So R is basically resistance per conductor. So here we are getting 322.752 as the line losses. So transmission efficiency is power output by power input. Power input is equal to power output plus losses. So it is coming to be 93.94%. So problem number one and problem number three, the only difference is that the problem number one we were solving for single phase transmission system, and problem number three we are solving for three phase transmission system. The next problem, problem number four for this tutorial is, the final problem is, estimate the distance over which a load of 15,000 kilowatt at power factor of 0.8 lagging can be delivered by three phase transmission. Now the special note is this is a three phase, so these quantities will be the three phase quantities. Having conducted each of resistance 1 ohm per kilometer. So the resistance of per kilometer is 1 ohm. The voltage at the receiving end, so the receiving end voltage is given to be 132 kV. Now again this voltage is the line voltage and the loss is given to be 5%. So what is the distance over which the load? So you have to calculate the total distance of the transmission line. So this problem is similarly to problem number 2. Only difference is that here you have a three-phase transmission system. So first you calculate the value of the current from the power formula. So power is basically root 3 VL IL cos phi. Since it is a three-phase system, you can take the line voltage and the line current you will obtain from the total three-phase power. So line current you are coming to be 82 amps. Now you have been given that 5% there is a power loss. So 5% of the receiving end power will be going in the losses in the line. So which is coming to be 750 kilowatt, because the receiving end power is 15,000 kilowatt. Now the total line losses will be 3 I square R, because 3 is the coming from the three phase system. Line losses you have calculated 750 kilowatt, and this resistance is per conductor of the line. So you have calculated the current as 82 amps, that give you the resistance 37.18 ohms. And we know that the resistance of each conductor per kilometer is 1 ohm, which is given in the problem. So total resistance you are getting 37.18. So per kilometer of the line you are getting 1 ohm, and the total resistance is 37.18, which means that the length of the line is coming to be 37.18 kilometer. So in this way we have completed the tutorial first part of the short transmission line, where we have calculated the single phase and three phase system, determined the efficiency, regulation and the length of the line. In the next part we'll solve few more problems. Thank you.